There's a division running through Germany. You can't see it, but here, deep in the country's heartland, it runs along this highway. People on either side live mostly the same lives. They use the same water, are served by the same police, pay the same taxes. But there's one difference. If you live south of the highway, in the town of Wolmirstedt, you can surf the internet with the kind of high-speed connection you'd expect in 21st century Germany. But move just a couple of fields and a highway away to the village of Mose in the north, and you'll barely be able to watch a movie online.
Man fühlt sich abgekapselt da,
wie so ein Spiegelbild für ganz Deutschland.
Und da ist Breitbandausbau so wichtig für Energie und so wichtig wie fließendes Wasser.
The two communities, located a two-hour drive west of Berlin, are a miniature version of Germany's internet situation. Across the country, in the darkest spots on this map, areas surrounding cities have high-speed access to the web, while in the lighter areas, there are communities that are de facto internet deserts. And increasingly, this is a problem.
But why has Germany failed to roll out faster internet, and what could be done to fix it?
The story of the village of Mose and its fight for better internet shows everything that's wrong with Germany's internet rollout. And this man is at the heart of that fight.
Internettechnisch waren wir immer sehr, sehr abgehängt und hatten da immer Probleme und haben uns auch jahrelang jetzt dafür schon eingesetzt. Ich bin Marco Röhrmann, wohne hier in Mose schon mein ganzes Leben, seit meiner Geburt, bin jetzt 36 Jahre alt und bin momentan der Ortsbürgermeister von Mose. Genau.
Politicians have been promising faster internet to people like him and places like Mose for more than a decade.
Ich bin davon überzeugt, dass die Zukunft der ländlichen Räume ganz wesentlich davon abhängt, dass die technischen Möglichkeiten dort dieselben sind.
Erstens wollen wir die Infrastruktur ausbauen, damit alle Menschen Zugriff zu den digitalen Möglichkeiten haben.
But again and again, national targets were pushed further into the future, first to 2018, then to 2025, and now some speak of 2030.
This is a story of how political decisions can shape infrastructure. It's a story of how markets and bureaucracy can help or hinder development. And it's a story that gains urgency when the pandemic hits and shows that a bad internet connection can literally impact your life. But first, let's see what this is all about.
When we connect to Wi-Fi at home, it's a bit like turning on a tap. We don't think about where the internet comes from or how it gets to us. It's just there. But the internet is a stream of data. Just like we need pipes to bring us water, we need cables to bring us the internet. And like the size of pipes affects water pressure, the material of cables affects how much data can flow through them. In Germany, there are essentially three options. There are old phone cables made of copper. They're the least powerful. Then there are TV cables, which allow for somewhat faster connections. And finally, there are fiber optic cables, which transmit data as light and are, by far, the fastest option. That's why the kind of cables connecting the internet to your home determine how fast your internet can be. And people in rural regions like Mose's home state Sachsen-Anhalt often draw the short straw. In the village, the internet still runs through a bunch of old copper phone cables dating back to the early 1990s. Unlike the town just a couple of fields and a road away, no one updated the connection here to TV or fiber optic cables.
Ja, und ich glaube auch, dass das auch wie so ein Spiegelbild für ganz Deutschland ist. 2 Kilometer weiter gibt es Internet, hier gibt es nichts.
But why is the situation as it is? In our research, we identified 3 key factors: politics, market failure, and bureaucracy. And when we looked into the first factor, politics, we realized that the idea of fiber optics actually goes back decades.
Helmut Schmidt speaking.
Back in the early 1980s, West Germany's Chancellor Helmut Schmidt, a social democrat, developed a 30-year plan to replace copper phone lines with fiber optic cables. But soon after, his conservative successor Helmut Kohl killed off the project. To this day, Chancellor Kohl's reasons are subject to debate. But West Germany did not roll out fiber optic cables on a large scale, and neither did Germany as a whole when it rolled out connections in its east after the country was reunified in 1990.
It's a timing question. Would have taken too long. And second of all, it's a question of cost. Who should pay for this? My name is Thorsten Gerbert. I'm a professor of telecommunications management. As long as we have the internet, I focus on the internet. And yeah, it's easy to say, well, why don't you put fiber in the ground? If there's nobody to finance it, then it's difficult.
The 1990s were ruled by the free market. The Cold War was over. Places like Germany's East all of a sudden were part of the freewheeling West, creating ripples that even reached places like Mosul. Which brings us to the second reason for why Germany's internet rollout is so bumpy: market failure.
Wir hatten in der Zeit auch die Liberalisierung der Märkte, also Energienetze, Versorgungsnetze allgemein, die bis dahin in kommunalen oder in staatlichen Händen waren, wurden ja alle liberalisiert. Mein Name ist Jutta Zühnow und ich bin verantwortlich in Neuss für ein Unternehmen, das sich mit dem Ausbau von Daten- und Elektronetzen beschäftigt und das seit 50 Jahren.
This 1990s wave of privatization also included Germany's state-owned telecom giant Deutsche Telekom, which operated the country's phone connections.
Da ist der fatale Fehler gemacht, um zu entscheiden, wenn wir schon liberalisieren, dann fangen wir da nicht wieder an mit einer staatlichen Regelung, sondern überlassen wir es an dem Punkt schon direkt dem freien Markt.
The idea was that once the market was privatized, companies would compete over customers, which would in turn force them to make them the best offer possible.
But that free market did not pay much attention to places like Mosul. Rather, companies focused on commercial areas and inner cities.
Es gibt Industriegebiete, die haben die Glasfaser dreimal nebeneinander liegen, obwohl sie einmal reicht.
Little villages like Mosul were left out in the cold.
They simply weren't interesting enough for profit-driven companies. The connections they were offered were often cheaper and slower than fiber. And policies from governments under Helmut Kohl to Gerhard Schröder to Angela Merkel encouraged companies offering those second-rate connections.
As recently as the mid-2010s, Merkel's government was introducing a new round of subsidies for connections as slow as 50 megabit per second.
But 50 Mbit was possible to reach based on copper cables, if you fine-tune a little bit with technology around those copper cables. But it's still copper cable. The Deutsche Telekom, which is our big incumbent company here, was just upgrading their copper cables because that was the smallest investment for them to reach this goal.
And you get what you pay for. Experts say that some of these connections will already be outdated in a few years.
This strategy of subsidy, funding old technology to live a little bit longer, was actively prohibiting or hindering the fiber optic build-out.
But why, you may ask, in a free market, don't communities take things into their own hands, apply for funding, and build their own fiber network? The problem is that current rules make it complicated for them. And this brings us to what in our research came up as the third great obstacle to Germany's internet rollout: bureaucracy.
Weil wir vom Dorf kommen, sind wir ja teilweise auch pragmatisch. Einer hat einen Bagger, einer hat einen Radlader, wir haben alle einen Spaten. Genau dieselben Überlegungen hatten wir auch, wir können auch hier selber buddeln, selber einen Strang reinlegen. Ja, da ist man ja natürlich auch so manchen behördlichen Zwängen und da kann man ja nicht machen. Und wem gehört das Land und alles schwierig. Und da ist man der deutschen Bürokratie natürlich, das ist da nicht förderlich, das stimmt schon.
And there's something else. The more we looked into the history of Germany's internet rollout, the more we realized that it's never really been a top priority for politicians, especially when it comes to places like Mosul.
Remember how we said connecting to the internet at home is a bit like turning on a tap? When it comes to water, people in Germany know the water will come and it will be clean. Access to clean water belongs to what is known as the Daseinsvorsorge. That's a list of basic public services that everyone has a right to.
which raises the question, in an age when people work from home or attend classes online, shouldn't access to decent internet be on that list of necessities? Now, to some, that sounds like a dream of tech radicals.
You have to set priorities in politics. You can spend the dollar or the euro only once. Overall, I'm not that sure whether there are not other areas which should be of higher priority.
But others say that our lives have moved online to such a degree that everybody now needs good internet.
Und da ist Breitbandausbau so wichtig für Energie und so wichtig wie fließendes Wasser auf dem Land.
You have to have a right to it, because without it you cannot participate in the society.
People here in Mosel learned that the hard way when the coronavirus pandemic hit.
Mein Name ist Jennifer Schulze, ich bin 37 Jahre, wohne in Mosel und arbeite als Telefonberaterin. Also unser Arbeitgeber hat versucht, uns auszulagern, sage ich jetzt mal, um die Abstände einzuhalten. Hat auch die ganze Technik dafür zur Verfügung gestellt. Wir haben es hier versucht, es hat nicht funktioniert. Das heißt also, ich war in dem Moment dann wieder gezwungen, ins Büro zu gehen. Teilweise hatte man wirklich Angst gehabt. Erstmal, man wusste nicht, wo, wie steckt man sich an, wen steckt man vielleicht noch mit an, gerade auch den Kollegen, wenn man nach Hause kommt. Vielleicht hat man sich auf Arbeit angesteckt, steckt man hier die Familie an. Es hat einfach nochmal aufgezeigt, wie wichtig es ist, eine normale Leitung zu haben. Zukünftig muss definitiv das Internet dafür geschaffen werden, gerade auf den ländlichen Regionen.
Und was, wenn nicht?
Dann werden die immer benachteiligt. Das sind dann Menschen zweiter Klasse, die auf dem Land sind.
So what now? How can Germany get out of this mess?
Yeah, you can tackle the problems directly. So talking about bureaucracy, of course, you need to simplify bureaucracy and make it less complicated.
Germany has already got rid of some red tape and included a right to the internet in a new law. And the number of faster connections, including in rural areas shown in this graph, is on the rise. But when it comes to powerful glass fiber connections, Germany still lags far behind countries like South Korea or Sweden.
And if you're wondering if the connection problems in places like Mosel might be solved by 5G mobile internet or Elon Musk's satellite network, they won't. The experts we talked to agreed that cable infrastructure will remain crucial in the coming decades.
Here in Mosel, at least, the future is slowly coming.
Ja, durch viele unterschiedliche, ob jetzt Corona, die Unternehmen, unser Engagement, führte dazu, dass wir jetzt wenigstens bis Mosel-Eingang Glasfaser liegen haben und dann über die alten Kupferleitungen etwas schnelleres Internet nutzen können.
Wie gesagt, wir freuen uns schon die ganze Zeit. Unser Kleiner, der wartet im Grunde genommen drauf, dass wir auch mal denn was zusammen spielen können, Online-Spiele oder so. Ist ja alles jetzt nicht möglich mit der Leitung, dass wir auch sagen können, so, wir sind jetzt im 21. Jahrhundert.
People were even promised that soon they could get glass fiber connections all the way to their homes.
Na gut, die Erfahrung jetzt mit dem regionalen Telekommunikationsunternehmen hat gezeigt, dass eigentlich getroffene Aussagen jetzt nicht unbedingt sich denn auch bewahrheiten. Ob das wirklich passiert, bin ich noch so ein bisschen skeptisch.
One thing the story of Mosel's painfully slow internet rollout shows us is that none of the chancellors of the digital age managed it very well. But Angela Merkel's era is coming to a close. In September's elections, Germans will decide who will follow her as chancellor, and the job of speeding up Germany's internet will be waiting on their to-do list.